talking about how to be assertive. So before we begin, I'd like to ask everyone a couple of questions. First of all, have you ever been afraid of raising your hand and asking a question in a seminar like this for fear of attracting negative attention to yourself? Or say, have you ever chickened out from asking someone on a date because you hesitated for too long? Or have you ever said yes to a party invitation that you probably don't have time or interest for? Alright, for those of you who have agreed with the question, I can't empathize with you all. I used to be very insecure about myself as a child and teenager. But not anymore. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Jason Riady, and I'm in the 12th grade. I'm an introvert by nature, who used to be very shy as a kid and as a teenager. There was once where the principal, Mr. Peter over there, called me up to the stage, and then I was asked to answer a couple of questions. But when I answered, I was stuttering and shivering. And Mr. Peter even said, "Jinha, you're shivering." I'm like, "Oh, God." And so after that, I decided to try and learn how to be more assertive about my positions, about whatever opinions I have, and to learn to assert it to others around me. Now, as a child, as a teenager, I wouldn't have shares if I was assertive or not. I would think, "Oh, that's me," and I would like to. And there are many factors to which I can blame it on. For example, I'm going through puberty at that time, so there are many behavioral, emotional, mental, hormonal changes going on. Heck, this whole thing changed. From a young age, I have told myself that when I grow up one day, I want to be someone who motivates others to do good for themselves and for those around themselves. And everyone, that will be my mission for today, to help you all learn how to be more assertive about yourself and to not be insecure. So, first of all, many of you may be asking, what does insecurity mean? Insecurity basically means that you are not fixed in your position, or when applied to humans, you are not reassured that your opinion is worthy. This problem affects many teens today, and not just teens actually, many adults are also affected because they have not yet learned a way to overcome this problem as a teen. Now, the remedy to this, as I have put in the presentation just now, is assertiveness. Assertiveness is the opposite of insecurity, wherein you are confident enough to take responsibility for whatever thoughts, words, actions you have expressed. So most of you may be wondering right now, why be assertive? Why can't I just stay insecure? I've gotten here and it's okay. Well, these are what you will be missing on. I've listed several reasons why we should be assertive, and to be honest, each of them actually connects to one another. When you're being assertive, you will try your best to be as truthful as possible about your feelings to others. By being truthful, you will view yourself in a more realistic light. You will stop comparing yourself and your flaws, your strengths to other people, and actually learn to see that everyone has their own differences. This will decrease your anxiety and depression and frees up a lot of time. When I say frees up a lot of time, I mean to say that you won't be worrying as much about yourself. And you have a lot, and that gives room for you to do some self-appreciation, which consequently leads to a more happier life. Now moving on, how will I get by solving this problem then? Well, here's a quote from Sun Tzu, the Chinese general who served during the Chinese Warring States period and wrote the book, The Art of War. He stated, "Know thyself, know thy enemy. 1,000 battles, 1,000 victories. What Sun Tzu is trying to say here is that if you understand the underlying factors that affects the condition of your side and side of who you're trying to overcome, then you will know, and then you'll be victorious. Victorious how? Well, if you know and understand the problem itself, then you will understand, you'll be able to derive ways of how to fix it. For example, if you understand what influenza is and how influenza is caused, then you will know how to cure it. So first of all, know thy enemy. When I talk about insecurity, I mean that in the way that it manifests itself in our daily life. And from my own experience, there are three ways in which it can manifest itself in daily life. The first way is underestimation. When I say underestimation, it means that you are underestimating the value of your own thoughts, opinions, and judgment as compared to everyone else. The most likely contributing factor to this is because maybe as a child, you have been conditioned to believe that your opinions are not as worthy as other people's opinions, and that they are inherently inferior. How? And from where? Well, to answer that, that conditioning can come from anyone around you, maybe from your parents, teachers, friends, enemies, siblings, anyone. In the form of statements such as, oh, you're stupid. That's such a foolish question. I didn't ask for an opinion. What did you see? And so on and so forth. Maybe the first few times you'll be enraged that you cannot express yourself. But this kind of, if you keep harboring this kind of attitude, then you will face some trauma. And then with prolonged exposure to such insults towards yourself, you will actually begin to internalize that fact that you are actually, that your opinions are inferior, and will continue thinking that way. A second manifestation of insecurity in your life is what I like to call nice guy syndrome, though this is not limited to guys. So basically, when I say nice guy syndrome, I'm referring to a person who tries to please all parties pressuring him, and trying to make no enemies at all. If you see politics, you'll know that that's impossible. Because say, I'm an insecure person, suffering from nice guy syndrome. If I have person A here telling me yes, and person B here telling me no, how am I supposed to please both of them at the same time? That would be an absolute contradiction. So as a result of having a nice guy syndrome, a person would be less willing to make decisions for him or herself, and have other people make that decision for him or herself. Although this status quo situation might be harmless, because A, someone's making your decisions for you, you don't have any personal responsibility, it will actually accumulate within your system in the form of anxiety, depression, and stress. And there's a limit to how much you can take. And as a result, once you can't take any more, you will be enraged. Enraged at the fact that everyone is stifling your decisions. Enraged at the fact that you cannot force yourself out. I have an anecdote to share with everyone. So for those of you who know me, 2 years ago, I had a girlfriend. And I can tell all of you that I really loved her. To the point where I would always try to make her happy all the time. A little bit of negativity from her would already make me tumble and crash. The thing here is that although I knew it's impossible to make her happy, I was stubborn and I tried anyway. There is just a big problem, however. She, by nature, is an extrovert. She really likes talking to me and a lot of people and likes to be company. Me, on the other hand, as I said before, I am an introvert. I appreciate the company of others, but at the same time, I appreciate my alone time too, as it gives me time to recharge. Now, she has a lot of expectations for me and expects me to actually go talk to her every single day, which I tried to do at first. And gradually, those sessions got longer and longer and longer, and my alone time got shorter and shorter and shorter. Now, I tried telling her, you know what, I need to be my alone time right now. This is not going to work out for us in the long run. But then, the usual reaction I get is that she's going to freak out at me. Freak out at the fact that I might be leaving her, that I might be losing interest in her, so on and so forth. So in the end, I decided to be my time. But then gradually, like I said, it took its toll on me. Little by little, I began to feel more and more stressed because I didn't have any alone time for myself. And that would end up at me being angry for all the time, throwing tantrums here and there. I don't normally get angry, so this is a bit freaky for me too. And in the end, she left me. Oh yes, she left me, and she also left me with 6 months of depression, though I don't blame her. So the lesson from that is that for all of you people who are harboring nice guy syndrome, Just stop. Just be yourself. So life is too short to adhere to whatever other people want you to be. You know? If people get this much time to live, they also deserve this much time. Don't live their life. One more manifestation of insecurity in our lives is what I think is the most dangerous one. It's a desire for conformity. Now, for those of you who don't know, conformity means the desire to be part of a bigger group and actually feel that you belong within that bigger group. However, there are sometimes this can go beyond the limit. Have any of you ever been through peer pressure before? If you did, then probably you want to do. Sometimes conforming is not always the best thing possible, and that it can lead to very, very irrational choices. So I have this book will hear from Judy Foster. It says, normal is not something to aspire to, it's something to get away from. Now, for my English class, I have been taught that the word normal is a tool in which people use to force others to conform to a societal standard, courtesy of Mr. Alex McMillan just now, who's my teacher. So basically, I want all of you to understand that when anyone throws out the N part of you, the normal part of you, don't pay attention to that. There is no such thing as normal. Normal is only a construct used to make people obedient and conform to other people. In the end, like I said, you won't be living your life. Now that you know thy enemy, it's time to know thyself. And when I say know thyself, I literally mean know thyself. This is how we begin solving the problem of insecurity. It takes a lot of time. But you can always start by, one, spending days detaching yourself from technology and people. Today, technology and media is everywhere. And if we're constantly bombarded with a lot of information, news, and so on and so forth, and we are expected, because of technology and access to technology and media, to always be updated with the latest pop culture references, with the latest scandals, with the latest Kim Kardashian dad, Kanye West dad, and so on and so forth. Technology can also serve as a tool. And by staying away from it, you get to start enjoying life, enjoying doing simple things in life. And from there, hopefully get to learn something. Another way, talk to someone that you trust and learn to evaluate yourself. From my own experience, I think that when you try to evaluate yourself, it wouldn't last long because whatever flaws you have, you try to rationalize it. You try to find an excuse within yourself to tell yourself, oh, why do I have this flaw? If you, however, confront another guy about these flaws, have this person tell you what your flaws and strengths are, then you will get a better chance at introspection yourself. Another way, and this one in particular worked very well for me, is to take a personality test. Now, I'm not saying that it's not a must, but we are all unique, yes, I understand that. But at the same time, there are others like ourselves out there, and if you were to take a personality test, then you can imagine that people probably act like you went through the exact same problems as you. And from that experience, you will get to learn how these people have to overcome such problems. And like I said just before, just be yourself. So, to describe what this MBTI personality test I was talking about, this is how it works. Basically, you either get sectioned into extroversion or introversion, whichever one you are more likely to incline. No one is 100% extrovert. No one is 100% introvert. People just find one way or another. You can find these kind of tests online, and I think they're quite accurate for the most part. So once you get the results, it will look like this, and you get to match with someone who shares a personality traits. For example, in my case, I'm an INTJ. That means that I am independent, I am studious, and I like to think my own way. That whenever people don't believe me, I will flash back to the past. Now, after finding out that I was an INTJ, I met up with Elvis and found out that he suffered from the very same problems I did. He was different as a child. He loved reading. He read all kinds of books, literature, novels, even how to build games, how to build a website. You know, he didn't socialize as much with those around him. It's kind of like me. You know, I like to keep to myself. I like to do what I like to do. I'm not really want to socialize with other people and there's no abuse for it. And so that itself already gave me enough self-introspection to make me comfortable with who I am, because I know that there are others like me out there and that they're living good lives right now. So why can't I? Okay. So finally, this is one last one I want everyone to know. This is my favorite quote of all time, and it's been the driving force behind everything I do, including this TEDx presentation. Says, you miss 100% of the shots you don't take. Simple as that. And I feel that it seems to me it's very thoroughly with everyone. All of you, by experience, should know that this is true. If there is anything that I can impart to you through this TED talk, it's that whatever problem you have, the key to solving it is already within your grasp. Insecurity is what distracts you from knowing that. And by being assertive, you get to retain the spirit and capability actually solve those problems and do good for those around you and yourself. Ultimately, I don't believe in what you call a predetermined destiny. And I believe that by being more certain about yourself, you get to begin to change your life for the better. Like, potentially laying down the first brick that will become the foundation for a better life in the future. Thank you, everyone.